Hello everyone, my name is Nomis, and welcome back to another episode, our second episode of Wasteland 2, the Director's Cut. We are picking up here right where we last left off, at the gate to the Wastelands. We are going to head there right now, travel there with our squad, gather your squad and travel to the Wasteland. All squad members will go to the new location. Yes. Alright, let's go. So last episode was kind of just the intro to this game. We kind of talked to General Vargas, got our first mission, which
Ranger
was to go check out a radio tower.
Is Ranger Command, come in.
Copy.
Roger, Echo One. Just making sure your radio is working. I'll be your dispatcher from here on out. I also wanted to give you a little heads up on your water situation. If you've all got full canteens, you should have enough water to reach the place where Ace died with plenty to spare. But if you're going to go exploring, you'll want to fill up again at any oasis you can find.
Okay.
Remember, your main priority is to recover the repeater units Ace was carrying. Once you've got the devices, you'll be headed to Ag Center and High Pool to install them. But we'll talk about that after you acquire the repeaters. We must, of course, bring Ace's killers to justice. But right now, that's secondary to discovering the location of that signal.
Okay, so as General Vargas has just said, we are going to go look for those repeaters and the site of Ace's murder so we can track down his killer. So it's important to stay in radio contact with you?
It is vital that all teams stay in radio contact with me here at the base. We get distress calls from all over our jurisdiction and sometimes beyond. Towns or farms or mines being attacked by raiders, mutant beasts, what have you. We field those calls here and then dispatch whichever team is closest to the problem.
Sounds good. Does that mean you weren't always a dispatcher?
Until now, Woodson's been our dispatcher. But Ace's death made me realize I've spent too many years in my office, walled off from the world and how it's changing. I need to know what's going on out there, and I figure the best way to do that is to start listening to the people's problems. So, I've decided that from now on, I'll be the one fielding calls and talking in your ear when you head out into the wastes.
Alrighty, Vargas.
Don't let that make you self-conscious or nothing.
Over and out.
10-4, Echo One, carry on. Ranger Command out.
Okay, so, this is the... these are the wastelands, I should say. And we're heading to... our first location, which is the radio tower, which is east. So let's, I guess we just start heading up this way. We got some more tips here. Radio, yeah, we know about that. The world map we know about, we just looked at. Oh, I guess I should have read some of those other ones. The outdoorsman skill determines your squad's search radius on the world map when traveling. I don't think I have a outworld or an outdoorsman skill in our group. So let's just keep moving on here. It'll take 6 water to get there. We've got 60 units of water. You can see down the bottom right here. Alright, so let's just make sure we're going the right way. Yep. And I guess we'll go up here, see if we can find a way around these mountains. You see dangerous raiders approaching your position. We can attack them or run. The running has a 25% chance. We're going to go ahead and attack them since this is going to be our first combat. So we can take a look at what the combat system looks like. Alright, so there we got the raiders. We got 2-3 raiders, it looks like. And we should be able to set up in positions here before they spot us. So we got some low cover here. We got a pillar we could send someone to. Let's see. We got the pistol lady. 2 people with pistols. Pills and the widow have pistols. Hex has the phase blaster. And I've got the M1 or sniper rifle. Any actions we do before actual combat, which the encounter just began right now. So that kind of sucks. But anything we do beforehand doesn't cost any action points. When people are in the way, there is a chance of us hitting them. And it looks like it's Hex's turn here. You can see the little star indicates that it's her turn. turn to attack. So I think what we're going to do is start putting people into position. So it's going to take 3 action points here to get to half cover. Gives 50 evasion and 10 to hit chance. So yeah, let's move her there. She'll have, let's see, where's her AP, total AP? Right here, 8. So she'll have 5 AP after this. You can see here it takes 2 AP to crouch, 4 AP to ambush, go into an ambush stance, 4 AP to reload, or 2 AP to reload, sorry. 2 or 4? No, 4, yeah. And then 4 AP to shoot. So we're going to send her here. And I think just shoot this guy. Ouch. Friendly fire. So yeah, that's exactly what we're talking about. So she has she has 1 AP left, but she can't do anything, so we're just going to end the turn. Alright, so now it's Pill's turn. She has 7 AP. Think. Should I just send her here? A little bit of cover. And go for that shot as well. We can go for a precision shot. Let's try that. 70%. Oh, we can actually target different parts of the body. I think this is new to the director's cut. All cost 3 AP, 11% chance to hit, 30% chance to hit. 35%, 35%. It's 60% chance to hit, sorry. Yeah, I guess we'll go for the headshot. Animus. Okay, we got 2 AP left. So that's enough to swap weapons. That's it though. I don't think we have enough. No, we don't have enough. Alright, I guess we'll just end the turn. And I'm gonna just take the shot here. There we go. Took for 4 damage. She has 5 AP left, so that's enough to either go into ambush mode. So ambush mode would be as soon as an enemy moves within her sight and her range, then she'll shoot them automatically. So we could shoot once and then go into a crouch. Crouching will give us a 20% chance to evade, 10% chance to hit. Let's crouch, and then we'll go for another shot here. 71%. I miss. I'm gonna kick your teeth in. Alright. We got some luck here. Luck shone down on us. Namas got bonus action points. Alright, so we got a 32% chance of hitting them, 57% out of range. I don't know, what should we do? Should we send them all the way over here? That's 6 AP. We'd be able to shoot once. Let's send them behind here. We'll have 5 AP left. That'll be enough for one shot. Precision strike. This guy, go for a headshot. Animus. Okay, end turn. Here comes the third opponent. So this guy's a melee weapon, so very low chance that he'll probably miss. 69%, 69%. I guess I'm gonna go after this guy. And go for the precision strike, I guess. So taking the precision strike, we lose a little bit of accuracy, don't we? So from 69% down to 60%. Damn it. Bound to hit some of these shots sooner or later. Try another precision shot. Let's go for the arm this time. It's only 30, it's so low. I guess we're gonna keep going for the head. Missed again. Oh dear. Oh dear. Alright, go for this guy. 70% Should hit him. There we go. Shoot him again. Very good. He's got 2 AP left. Not enough to do anything. So we'll end the turn. Try and finish this guy off. There we go. And let's go into... Let's go... it takes 3 AP. Alright, let's just go into ambush. Damn it, friendly fire. It was a chance. That was a miss. It's cool on the right here, we got the everything that's happened. A Raider Gunslinger hits Widow O'Neill for 8 points of damage and 9 points of damage. So we're taking quite a bit of damage here. Let's see here, 67% sight blocked. I guess we're going after this guy. There we go, 12 damage. Nice. 6 AP left, we got enough for one more shot. Let's try and finish this guy off. There we go. Taking careful aim, Nomus pegs a Raider Cutter, doing 9 points of damage, putting an end to his screaming once and for all. Alright, 2 AP left. I think we'll just stay here. End turn. Mania? Widow O'Neill is manic. Alright, we gave her that trait, right? 19%, let's just put her into ambush? Let's try that. It's such low percentage, I'm just gonna put these all into ambush. I'm gonna move her over here. So hopefully we get out of friendly fire range. Oh, we missed both of those. Put her open to a shot. Oh, she's gonna go down here if we don't heal her up. Let's see here. I'm gonna throw Nomus down behind here. And we should still have enough to get a shot on this guy. Let's do that. Oh, our weapon jammed. So we're gonna have to unjam that the next turn. Oh man, he's in a tricky position here. Let's send her down here. Or wait, she's not our medic. Where's pills? Send her down there. Try and flank this. Alright, 2 AP left. That's fine. So I could send pills over here to try and heal Widow. Low dosage of pain relievers. Left click to use. Effects heals 12 points of condition. Basic trauma kit. Heals 20% of condition upon recovering. Or a pocket medic pack. Heals 26 to 37 points of condition. Left click to use. I don't know who's next. Widow O'Neill is next. I might just send her. I don't know what I should do, guys. I might send her behind the pillar. Put her on ambush again. Yeah, let's send her behind the pillar and then she'll have some cover. Put her on ambush as well, I guess. Someone get a hit on him. Right, they missed. His weapon jammed. Alright, 54%. Let's see here. Won't let me aim on him. Okay. Right there. Give me a hit. Damn it. Alright, try again. There we go. So our phase blaster is empty. We're gonna have to reload that. It does take 4 AP to reload though, so we're gonna have to end this turn here. our weapon is jammed. So we're gonna have to unjam that. That'll take 5 AP. And we have enough for one shot. Hopefully it's a hit. And it's a miss. Lots of misses today. Alright, enter. And up to pills again, isn't it? Should I just send her up close? If I send her here, will she have any better aim? Oh, we can grab some pills off of this guy. Take all. I guess we can loot them. That's right. What should I do, guys? How much ammo? Where's our ammo? Where's our ammo count, guys? It takes 3 AP to reload. We'll just go for a... I don't know, 18%, it's still low. We'll try. Maybe we'll get lucky. No. No. Alright, end turn. Alright, he unjammed. Another hit. Gotta reload. Okay, 5 AP. Maybe I should move behind here. Alright, come on, give me a hit. There we go. Out of sight. Out of sight, out of sight. Oh, we do have some pills on us. Let's use these, I guess. There we go. Got a little bit of health left. And let's see, we got 3 AP left. I'm gonna leave you here for now. We'll put you on ambush. I'm just gonna move you out to get a clear shot. 59%, here we go. Kill him! There we go, look at that. Last shot. So we killed 2 Raider Cutters and 1 Raider Gunslinger. Pills attacks a Raider Gunslinger, doing 6 points of damage, dropping him like a stone. Encounter ends. Alright, let's pick up whatever loot we can off of these bodies. I got some glasses, okay. And looks like we got a pistol. A VP-91Z. Some ammo and a deck of cards. Take all that. Okay, so that should be everything, right? They looted this guy too. Okay, we'll reload. Okay, everyone's reloaded. Health is a bit of a situation here. I can't remember how the healing works if we heal while we're out in the field. I guess we'll find out. Hex is at 9, 21, 14. Alright, so let's move out of here. Find the exit. No, it's not over there. It must be up here. Yeah, there it is. Alright, let's move to the exit. Yeah, travel. Exit this encounter. Yep. Smart Ranger always checks his ammo count before starting combat, not after. So that could have gone better for us if we would have had time to set up our people. We'll do better next time. Alright, looks like we're heading into a little bit of radiation. Yeah, there's some radiation zone up there. Move over here. You see dangerous raiders approaching your position? I guess we're going to have to attack them, aren't we? Let's see if our health went up at all. It did not. Encounter begins already. Ouch. Right, we got 3 people again. We should be able to find some cover here, though. Alright, you are almost dead, so I'm gonna send you there. And shoot him. Okay, a little bit of damage. Two, not enough. What other weapons do we have? Can I look at our inventory here? No, you don't have another weapon. But I could give you this. Can I give it to you? Yep. Could give you that. And maybe some pistol ammo? How do I split this? Can I split this? How do you split, guys? Not sure how you split ammo. So if I go like this. Oh, there we go. We'll give you 10. Oops. 10, okay. Keep the rest. Yeah, that's fine. You got pistol ammo. So let's give you. You got pills, okay. I think we're good. How about you just take pill 6 for AP? Okay, we'll just end the turn then. Alright, pills. You. Probably take some cover. Try and take this guy out. Really? A miss from that close? That's unfortunate. Alright, end the turn. You want the knife? Brandishes his weapon, a raider cutter appears at 28 meters away. Alright, and let's see, no miss. Let's just put no miss here. Try and shoot this guy. Oh, he's too close, I guess? Well, that's unfortunate. I guess we're gonna have to go for this guy. That's a miss. Oh god. She's down. She's bleeding out. We gotta get to her. Alright. Oh my god. She's almost dead. I guess. We gotta take out some raiders here. I gotta send pills back to revive Hex. I hope we get a hit there. Nice. And crouch. Good miss on pills. Two misses. Excellent. Alright, we're heading back here. And use our basic trauma. Select the surgeon skill on the left. Click to use. Surgeon, field medic. This skill will help you patch up your friends just enough to get them to a real doctor. Field medic restores hit points and removes effects by using consumable items. This action is available in and out of combat. I think we want to use the surgeon. The skill allows you to fix the deep damage and bad breaks that a field medic isn't qualified to. You'll be a lifesaver. Surgeon skill is used to revive down squad members. Yep, so we're going to use this skill on Hex. We will use one of our basic trauma kits. Ouch. A raider. There we go. Let's get down. Oh no. We're getting destroyed here, guys. Okay. So whose turn is it? Mine. 42%, 0%, 17%. Okay. I guess I'm going after this guy. Come on. Take him out. My lord. End the turn, I guess, so I could switch weapons. What's my other weapon? The sniper rifle? The sniper rifle, yeah. Should I switch out to the sniper rifle? Let's switch out to the sniper rifle. Oh, I gotta reload that too? Damn. Maybe not. Alright, well, I don't know. Where should I send him? In here? Take cover behind this? Can I? No, I can't. Uh-oh. This doesn't look good, guys. Alright, stay there, I guess. Or maybe, no, fall back. So at least they have to move to attack me. Oh god. Oh god. I'm bleeding out. Alright, she's up. And it's Pill's turn. Alright, so I gotta get over here. I gotta heal this person. Alright, bring her up. Use it. Miss! Thank you. Miss! Thank you. Hex is no longer afflicted by bleeding out. Hex is healed for 12 condition. Go to the bottom of this. There we go. Alright, who is this? Hex. 68%. I guess so. Hopefully it's a hit. Don't hit Pills. Nice. Oh. Just destroyed him. My god. Ouch. And three left. Nothing we can do. Okay, end turn. Please miss. God damn it. God damn it. Okay, I gotta move this guy. I gotta move Nomis. And I think I gotta take some pills. Okay, healed. End turn. Alright, we're all up. Widow O'Neill has lost bleeding out. She's got stiffness, though. Okay. Let's send... Can I send someone to take cover over here? Yeah. So if I send them there, we should be able to shoot from behind. Oh god, miss. Oh god. Don't hit. Oh my god. No miss is down. I'm getting destroyed, guys. I'm getting wrecked. Alright, I gotta shoot this guy. And again. Alright, end turn. Alright, Widow is up. Let's see here, 67%. I guess I'll go for that shot, hey? Okay, you're down. Try that shot. Nice. Needed that. I needed that. Who's up now? Who's up now? Pills? Yeah. 19%. Let's move here. Get a little bit more cover. Up to 20%. I guess we'll take a shot. Nope. And let's go into ambush. Miss! Thank you. Alright, where's Pill? Oh no, the Pills is all the way. I gotta bring Pills back. Excuse me, I gotta bring Pills back. Go here. Gotta go there. Jesus. End turn. And gotta go here. End turn. Alright, Pills, come back. Come back and save Nomis. Alright, end turn. Please miss. Thank you. Thank you. Let's move you up to here. Get a shot. Should we go for a targeted shot? Go for a headshot? Nice. A Raider Gunslinger is now afflicted by concussion effects. So we gotta reload after that. I've gotta revive Gnomus, our last field kit. And let's send you over here, get a better shot. Come on, finish it up. Just gotta finish it up for us. Thank God. Thank God. Reload. And kill him. Nope. Alright, we're up. We're up. Alright, pills. Head over. I guess here. Out of range. Okay. Ambush. And Gnomus. I know your health is pretty low. We'll send you right there. Maybe we'll switch out that and we'll reload. Oh, we can't. Okay, we gotta get more AP to reload. Let's put you on ambush. Come on. Hit him! He had to reload. I have to reload? No, I'm good to go. Alright, let's just move in for the kill, I guess. Let's go right here. 58%. Come on! You're killing me here. Alright, moving right there. Ambush. Kill him. Ow. Bleeding out. That was probably it. Oh my god, bleeding out. Alright, reload. Take this guy out. Not enough AP. Oh, it takes 6. Alright. Kill him already. Oh, thank god. Squad XP gained. Jesus. So what are these? Okay, yeah, we can loot bodies, we know that. There are loot containers in some areas, okay. Keep an eye out for that. When a squad member takes enough damage, they will be incapacitated. There are several states of incapacitation represented by a squad member having less than 0 constitution, not condition. And they become progressively more severe if left untreated. For an incapacitated squad member to survive, they must be healed using a certain skill and a certain kit. If only knocked unconscious, a squad member may gain the mending status. Okay, we don't have time for all this. Okay. Critically wounded. Pills. We can't help anyone! Are we gonna lose 2 people? We're gonna lose 1 person for sure. Alright, check this body. Find a medkit. Take all. Oh shit. We can't do anything. Oh my god, we're gonna lose him. I can't do anything, guys. I don't have any. Alright, one sec. Do I have any medkits on anyone? No, I just have that pocket medkit. Wow. We already lost a member. I can't do anything for her. Like, I can't heal. I can't do this. Oh, I can't do anything. Alright, well, let's just try and leave. Maybe she won't die if we get to the exit soon enough. Where's the exit? Right there. Damn it! I guess so. There's nothing else we can do, right? Damn it. Oh no. We got someone back. mortally wounded. A lethal and unstable state resulting from the most serious injuries or poisoning. There is impaired oxygen supply to major organs and multi-system failure, which almost inevitably leads to death unless treated by a highly skilled surgeon. Revive with surgeon skill. So should we... Okay, there's an oasis here. We can fill up our water. Should we be heading back... to the Citadel to maybe buy a med kit. I'm gonna end the episode here, guys. Let me know in the comments below if that's what we should do. Hit that like button if you enjoyed. And yeah, stay tuned for the next episode. We'll see if we can save Hex. It would suck to lose a team member so early on. But yeah, that'll do it for today, guys. Until next time, I'll talk to you all later.